Power of Truth coming to you from ABN TV channels, Houston, Texas, USA, every Sunday at 6 to 6:30 p.m. Join the Minister of God, Pastor I.G. Fakunle, the Apostolic Church Area Superintendent, Ilesha, Osun State, Nigeria. For inquiries, call this number, +234-906-481-1278, +234-906-481-1278. Remember, it is every Sunday at 6 to 6:30 p.m. on ABN TV channels, Houston, Texas, USA. Jesus is Lord.
We want to thank the Lord for the grace to be alive and to be functioning for Him on the land of the living. You are welcome to this Power of Truth message. And I pray that as you listen, the glory of the Lord in your life will continue to shine. Today, by the grace of God, I be speaking on faith that works. The faith that works. Come with me to the book of Hebrews, the 11th chapter and verse 6. But without faith, it is impossible to please Him. For he that cometh to God must believe that He is, and that He is a rewarder of them that diligently seek Him. Faith that works. Talking about faith, faith makes difficult things possible to achieve. Where there is faith, there is no impossibility. Where there is faith, God takes the glory. Where there is faith, fear jumps out through the window. Because the two cannot coexist at the same place. So, when faith is properly exercised, out of love and obedience to God, it yields positive results. And so, in certain part of the scripture, we read many things about faith. But I want to dwell majorly on 2 Kings chapter 4. 2 Kings chapter 4. In this 2 Kings chapter 4, we have three outstanding facts concerning faith in the way God related to three important individuals mentioned in that chapter. Number one, we want to see the relationship of faith. The relationship of faith. In 2 Kings chapter 4 and verse 17. Second Kings chapter 4, verse 17 says, "And the woman conceived and bare a son at that season that Elisha had said unto her, according to the time of life." Here was a woman who had been barren for many years, but she put her faith into action through good relationship. And that faith changed her life. See, in that 2 Kings chapter 4, we are going to see certain things put into action by this woman. 2 Kings chapter 4, verse 3. It reads, "Then he said, Go, borrow thee vessels abroad of all thy neighbors, even empty vessels, borrow not a few." What happened here? This woman was the wife of a prophet who had died, and there was nothing at home. So she was indebted, and she had to use her children as surety for them. So she went to the man of God and cried, "Help me." And the man of God said, "Okay, there are certain things you need to do. Go and borrow vessels." Because the woman had told the man of God that she had just one bottle of oil. And the man of God said, "That is just all that God needs. Just one bottle to meet your needs." And that is one aspect of faith. There are many people, they thought until they have a very big faith, that is when God can perform in their lives. No, no. Jesus Christ said, "If you have faith as small as the grain of mustard," that's all. And that was what happened to this woman. So we see here one thing that is potent and pertinent to practical faith. And what is that? Relationship. Relationship. This woman was told to go and borrow vessels from her neighbors. Imagine what would have happened if this woman had not had good relationship with other people around her. Nobody would have given her, and she would have been wallowing in sorrow because of bad relationship. What is your relationship with other people? What is your relationship with God? You need to build a functional relationship with God and others for your faith to be positive. Number two, in verse 4 of that 2 Kings chapter 4, "And when thou art come in, thou shalt shut the door upon thee and upon thy sons, and shall pour out into all those vessels, and thou shalt set aside that which is full." You see here, this woman was told to go and pour. It is very important that you understand this aspect of faith in your life. Pour your faith out. Pour your faith out. Don't say my faith is too small, is this, like that. Pour it. Let your faith affect that thing that you are asking God for. Then number three, in verse 7, 2 Kings 4, 7, "Then she came and told the man of God, and he said, Go, sell the oil, and pay thy debt, and leave thou and thy children on the rest." You see, she was told to go and sell. The same thing in your life. When you want God to be actively involved in your life, you must go out and sell Jesus to other people. When you go out and sell Jesus to other people, God will be highly interested in whatever concerns you. It's very, very important. You see, your relationship with God and others is very important to achieve result. Without good relationship with others, no one would have given this woman what she needed to solve her problems, and her miracle will have missed her. Now we move to the second one in this chapter. This was the story of the Shunammite woman. In that 2 Kings chapter 4, from verse 12 to 13. There we read, and he said to Gehazi, his servant, call this Shunammite. And when he had called her, she stood before him. And he said unto him, say now unto her, behold, thou hast been careful for us with all this care. What is to be done for thee? Wouldest thou be spoken for to the king or to the captain of the host? And she answered, I dwell among the people. Here in this passage, the Bible said this woman should be called. And that is basic to faith. Have you been called by God? Have you heard the call of God? Because if you did not hear the call of God, there is no way a miracle can take place in your life. You need to hear the call of God upon your life. This woman was called, and she answered. And what do I mean by the call of God? That means the call of the gospel. When you are the call of Jesus Christ and you give yourself to the gospel of the Lord Jesus Christ, then something miraculous is bound to happen in your life. In verses 14 and 15, and he said, what then is to be done for her? And Gehazi answered, verily, she had no child, and her husband is old. And he said, call her. And when he had called her, she stood in the door. This is the call of hope. Here was a woman whose husband was old, no future, but she held to her hope in the power and the efficacy of the word of God. So the same thing in your life, you need to embrace the call of hope in your life. You don't look at things as if they can never be turned to something palatable for you again. No. See what is dark as what is bright. In other words, be pessimistic. Do not allow evil thoughts. See, be optimistic. Don't be pessimistic. There are many people, they are so pessimistic in the way they feel things in life. In fact, they will begin to curse themselves instead of clinging to hope. It's very important that you do not lose hope in whatever you are doing with God. Then, number 3, in verse 3 to 35, there the Bible says, and the mother of the child said, as the Lord liveth, and as thy soul liveth, I will not leave thee. And they arose and followed her. See, here the only hope of this woman, the child, was dead. But this woman, you see, had another call. When the man of God came and prayed for their child, and the child was brought back to life. What do I mean by that? The call of restoration. You see, when you hear the call of the gospel, you inquire about the power of God, you sustain your call of hope, definitely the call of restoration will follow. This woman's hope was not dashed. It is very, very important. Then, the last one that I'm going to speak on this chapter, was the story of the sons of the prophets. See, these people came to the prophet, and as they were eating, they discovered that there was poison. And so they cried, "Oh, man of God, there is poison in this food. Let us see what Elisha did." In that, 2 Kings chapter 4, verse 38. "And Elisha came again to Gilgal, and there was a drought in the land. And the sons of the prophets were sitting before him. And he said unto his servant, Set on the great pot, and set pottage for the sons of the prophets." They brought out the pot, they put in, they sit there, they put in the food, but unfortunately, there was poison in it. This is the pot of necessity. There are certain things in your life which are very, very necessary for you, but which you find no way of achieving them. They have turned to poison in your life. But the Lord said that as far as He is concerned, He has the power to turn every poison in your life to something palatable. He has the power to remove the poison. He has the power to remove anything, any agent of death in your life. You see, because in that chapter 40, the Bible said, "So they poured out for the men to eat. And it came to pass, as they were eating of the pottage, that they cried out and said, Oh, thou man of God, there is death in the pot, and they will not eat thereof." Maybe there are things in your life which you have been expecting to work for you positively, but which are not working positively. Take hope. Jesus has the power to turn every poison to good and eatable thing without poison. That is what Jesus Christ can do in your life, because that is what we get in verse 41. But he said, "Then bring meal," and he cast it into the pot. And he said, "Pour out for the people, that they may eat." And there was no harm in the pot. Do you see that? When Jesus Christ comes into your life, every poison will be removed. When you exercise your faith in the Lord Jesus Christ, every poison will be removed. Why am I saying all these things?
This is the Power of Truth coming to you from ABN TV channels, Houston, Texas, USA, every Sunday at 6 to 6:30 p.m. Join the Minister of God, Pastor I.G. Fakunle, the Apostolic Church Area Superintendent, Ilesha, Osun State, Nigeria. For inquiries, call this number, +234-906-481-1278, +234-906-481-1278. Remember, it is every Sunday at 6 to 6:30 p.m. on ABN TV channels, Houston, Texas, USA. Jesus is Lord.